The fight against tigers in Kenya has been long and tough. Although not in the limelight, the parasite has caused great damage to its victims indiscriminatingly. The parasite, which arrived in Africa in the 17th century, has given a hardy Kenya Trust an endless nightmare, and since then, the organization has been on the battlefield to eliminating the jigger scourge. The jiggers enter the body through the legs, causing vast damage to bones and rendering a person immobile, like Mzee Njuguna, who is now forced to use his backside to move around. As a result, Mzee Njuguna in his late 80s has hardly walked in his life. Sharing of pins and needles while removing the stubborn insect has also caused the spread of HIV/AIDS amongst communities infected by the jiggers. An unlucky victim was 6-year-old Julius Minor, who contracted the deadly virus through an infected pin, making efforts by a hardy Kenya Trust difficult since his state had deteriorated, and this led to his demise. After hearing about jiggers claiming the lives of two men in Juja, a hardy rushed to the rescue, only to find Yokabi Kariro helpless and bedridden. The organization has since been attending to her, and she's faring on well on the road to recovery. Foodstuff, clothing and sanitation equipment were also on their list of donations for the victims in the area. Another fascinating story is that of Hannah Wanjiru, who lives with her 5 children in a collapsing clean house in Gitai Village, Kandara location in Murang'a District. Wanjiru was rescued by a hardy after word went out that she was cleansing her jigger-infested children with diesel. Wanjiru resorted to the use of diesel for lack of finances to seek specialized treatment for her children. The stubborn pest has also disrupted learning in many parts of the country. Even with the introduction of free primary education, students have not been attending classes regularly, leading to low class turnout and deterioration in academic performance. A survey commissioned by a hardy trust in primary schools shows that about 720 pupils are suffering from jigger infestation within one location in Murang'a only. Others have become social outcasts after being disowned and neglected by not only members of their community, but their families. This leads to the victims not only suffering physically, but emotionally, mentally, and psychologically. In most cases, due to physical damages to the body, the victims cannot work, therefore they cannot fend for themselves. A hardy has reconstructed many of their lives by also conducting community demonstrations on sanitation to try and curb further damage by the deadly bug. One such happy ending story is that of Bwire, who besides being treated, fed and clothed, was supplied with farm equipment and is now leading a normal life. 3 members of one family in Kitaldal village in Belgut division were rescued by a good Samaritan who hired an ambulance and ferried them to Kericho District Hospital following an attack of the jigger menace, where they were admitted. A father, his wife and a 28-year-old son were unable to sit or walk as their backsides and legs have been infested by the parasites. On their road to a jigger-free Kenya, a hardy trust came across some members of the community who removed jiggers from victims' feet at a fee. At the beginning of every academic year, Mzee Juma finds himself between a rock and a hard place, assembling children of Burani in Kwale District to conduct a jigger-removing exercise. This problem is a blessing and a curse, since the removers use a sharp metal rod, which poses an HIV/AIDS risk among other transmittable diseases. We are appealing for your support in order to ensure that our society is a jigger-free society. Help remove my jigger.